我们听到来自勾尔丹山的一个牧牛童勾帕库马尔的旅程，他唱诵着一首 mantra， 他在这个物质宇宙，甚至去了超过这个物质宇宙，去灵性天空旅行。
So we heard how Gop Kumar went to Tapoloka, planet above the heavenly planet, and above Maharloka and Janaloka, there's a planet called Tapoloka.
我们听到 Gopa Kumar 他旅行到了天堂之后呢，又去了天堂之上的 Mahaloka， 之后他去了 Tapaloka。
So in Tapaloka he saw the four Kumars were there with many others who were also like them, and they were all engaged in meditation.
他在塔帕洛卡上见到了库马尔四兄弟以及和库马尔四兄弟一样的其他的人，这些人都在从事于冥想。
So Gop Kumar saw that everywhere he went, the people were all engaged in meditation and they were absorbed in samadhi. They had achieved the highest stage of meditation.
无论 Gopa Kumar 去哪里，他看到所有的人都在那里深深地陷入冥想当中，他们已经达到了冥想的最高境界。
And we remember the nature of Tapoloka was that everybody there, they were lifelong celibates.
我们要记住，在塔帕洛卡上，人们每一个人在那里的天性就是他们终生都在遵守。
And they had fulfilled all their desires.
他们实现了所有的心愿。
And so when Gop Kumar was there, It was certainly a big change from him from other places. It was a very different mood.
当 Gopa Kumar 在那里的时候，对他的人生是一个很大的改变，因为每个人的心态是不一样。
Now usually Gop Kumar, he always had the desire, he wanted to see the Supreme Lord and to associate with him and render service directly to him.
通常勾帕库马尔的心愿是想要见到宇宙之主，想要臣服他，为他做服务，直接为他做服务。
But on Tapoloka, the Lord was only in the heart of the living entities, and all the devotees there on Tapoloka, they were all meditating on the Lord in the heart.
但是在塔帕洛卡上，主是在每个生物的心中。所有的生物体呢，他们只是在那里冥想心中的至尊主。
And because Gop Kumar was staying there on Tapoloka, so he got influenced by the association of the great sages there.
因为戈帕库马尔他现在身在塔帕洛卡上，他就受到在那里的伟大圣哲的影响。
And all practically almost lost the desire to actually see the Supreme Lord.
他几乎就已经失去了想要见到至尊主的愿望了。
So Gop Kumar remained there on Tapoloka for some time because he was attracted by the great power which these great sages had.
Gopa Kumar 在塔帕洛卡上停留了一段时间，因为他受到这些圣哲的伟大圣哲的巨大的力量所吸引。
So long as he was there, Gop Kumar was chanting his mantra because he remembered the order of his guru.
当 Gopa Kumar 在 Tapaloka 星球上的时候，他还一直在唱诵着自己的 mantra， 因为他一直服务 guru 的训示。
He was seeing how powerful the mantra was, so his faith in the mantra was increasing.
他见证了这首 mantra 的力量，因此他的信心倍增。
So the atmosphere.On Tapoloka appealed that it weakened Gop Kumar's it weakened his determination to see the Lord.
在塔帕洛卡上的氛围呢，削弱了Gopa Kumar 想要见到至尊主的愿望。
Because everybody there was just meditating, and they were satisfied to see the Lord in meditation.
因为那里的人人都在冥想，因为冥想至尊主而已经心满意足了。
So Gopkumar, still Gopkumar had the determination to keep chanting his japa.
但是 Gopakumar 仍然下决心念诵自己的 japa.
His guru had told him never stop chanting this mantra.
他的 guru 告诉他永远不要停止念诵这首 mantra.
So Gopkumar did not want to be ungrateful and disobey the order of his guru.
Gopakumar 不想忘恩负义，违背 guru 的训示。
So, thanks to Gopakumar was feeling some peace in his heart because of the nature of that place where he was in Tapaloka. He could feel peace in his heart.
Gopakumar 现在在 Tapaloka 上，他感到内心非常平和。
Because it was way up in the top of the universe, so it was very much in the mode of goodness. There was hardly no passion or ignorance.
因为 Tapaloka 就在宇宙的中高星系上，那里的没有激情和愚昧属性。
So he was inspired to chant his mantra more than usually.
他比以前更加受到激励，念诵自己的 mantra.
And he would chant with more attention than he used to chant.
他比以前更加专注地念诵了。
And that way, his desire to see the Lord began to increase.
这样一来呢，他想要见到至尊主的愿望就变得强烈起来。
In the beginning, when he first came to Tapaloka, that the pure atmosphere of Tapaloka influenced him in the other way, in another way, because he became less interested to see the Lord.
他刚到 Tapaloka 上的时候，那里的氛围呢，影响到他，使得他见到至尊主的愿望减弱了。
Because on Tapaloka, everyone was taking, they were all self-satisfied. They were taking pleasure in the soul.
因为在 Tapaloka 上面，人们都是心满意足的，在灵魂自我。已经在灵魂的层面上找到了满足。
And nobody had the desire to actually enjoy the company of the Lord.
没有人想要享受和与主为伴的快乐。
They were all just satisfied meditating on the Lord.
他们只是满足于冥想至尊主。
So that in the beginning, Gopakumar was influenced by that atmosphere.
所以一开始 Gopakumar 就受这种气氛影响了。
But that peace of mind which he felt, it gradually began to help him to improve his chanting.
但是他逐渐的他的心意平和之后呢，他反而增加了自己的念诵。
And then the mantra which he was chanting exerted again, it has its own influence on him.
而且他所念诵这首 mantra 对他造成了影响。
We give an example.Sanatana Goswami gives an example in his purport. He said, just like ghee poured on a fire, it seems to put out the fire in the beginning.
Sanatana Goswami 打了一个比喻，就好像一开始像火中浇黄油的时候，好像是把火焰扑灭了一样。
But then the fire grows bigger than it was before.
但随后呢，这火焰就开始熊熊燃烧起来。
So the atmosphere in Tapaloka, it decreased Gopakumar's desire in the beginning to see the Lord.
因此，在 Tapaloka 的氛围一开始就削弱了 Gopakumar 想见主的心愿。
But later on, it helped to increase his desire.
但随后呢，他反而增加了他的愿望。
So one of the great sages there on Tapaloka was a person named Vipalayana.
在 Tapaloka 上，其中的一个伟大圣者名叫 Vipalayana.
So this person, Vipalayana, he could understand that Gopakumar was desiring to go to Jagannath Puri to see Lord Jagannath.
Vipalayana 看出 Gopakumar怀着想要去扎格纳的普瑞见主扎格纳的心愿。
So the sage Vipalaya came to speak to Gopakumar.
于是这位圣人便来跟 Gopakumar 讲话。
Gopakumar, remember, he had already been there in Jagannath Puri, and he'd become the king of Puri for some time, and He was having some association with Lord Jagannath.
Gopal Kumar 还能回忆起自己曾经一度就在扎纳普瑞，并且当了那里的国王，服务主扎格纳特。
So he had a thought to go back to Jagannath Puri. Sometimes the desire would come back in his mind and he would think, I should go back to Jagannath Puri.
因此他也时不时的就能回想起这个心愿，他想再回 Jagannath Puri.
When he was in the heavenly planets, he had that happen to him. The desire came in his heart.
当他在天堂的时候，这个心愿也曾经一度潜入他的心中。
And then he went to Mahaloka, and again the desire came in his heart.
之后他去 Mahaloka 的时候，这种心愿又再次在他心中升起来。
And now he's in Tapaloka, and still Lord Jagannath's coming into his heart, and he's thinking about going back to Jagannath Puri.
现在即便他已经来到 Tapaloka 上的时候，主扎格纳特也依然来到他的心中，使他再次想回到那里。
Now, usually Lord Jagannath, he doesn't manifest himself in these places, in the heavenly planets, in the planets of the demigods or the great sages. There's no Lord Jagannath there.
通常而言，主扎格纳特不会在天堂显现，不会在这高等星系上显现。
So this Pipalayana, who's come to speak to Gop Kumar, he is one of the Nava Yogendras, the nine Yogendras, who are ninth among the 100 sons of Lord Rishabhdev. Nine of them were called the nine Yogendras.
主Rishabhdev有一百个儿子，其中有九位叫称为 Nava Yogendra， Pipalayana Muni 就是九位 Yogendra 之一。
Rishabhdev had 100 sons.
Rishabhdev 他有100个儿子。
And so nine of them were these Navayogendras.
其中九位呢，就是这九位 Navayogendra.
So this Pipalayana, he's a self-realized soul, and he's omniscient. He knows everything around him.
Pipalayana 是已经自我觉悟的灵魂。他知道他周围的一切事情。
So he saw Gop Kumar wandering around without any purpose, and he looked very sad.
他看到 Gopal Kumar 四下里漫游，看上去有点悲伤。
And he could tell that, so Pipalayana, he could tell just from the look on the face of Gop Kumar, he could understand something about what was going on in his mind.
琵琶拉亚纳从勾帕库马的行为举止当中就能看出他的心理。
So he's going to talk to Gop Kumar, and they'll have a very nice discussion, very important for us to hear.
他就即将跟勾帕库马讲话，这个对话是非常重要的，我们应该很好的去聆听。
So the sage says to Gop Kumar, he said,Why do you want to leave this place? This is such an exalted, very special place.
Pipalaya Muni 就对 Gopal Kumar 说，你为什么要离开这个崇高的地方？
And why are you wandering around so anxious to see the Supreme Lord with your eyes?
你为什么四下漫游，想要亲眼用你的双眼去见到至尊主？
So this sage Pipalayana,He's like the Sanat Kumar, the great sages on Tapaloka, they all engage in meditation.
Sanat Goswami 就说，在 Tapaloka 上的伟大圣者们都在冥想。
And they just see the Lord in their heart.
他们只是一味的在心中去见至尊主。
So in Pipalayana's opinion, he thought that this attempt to see the Lord with your eyes is useless.
根据皮巴拉亚的穆尼的意见，想要用肉眼去见至尊主的这努力是没有用的。
Because he says that it's, you know, that the senses, the material senses, you can never see the Lord by material senses.
因为至尊主是不能用物质的感官所见到。
Tapaloka, this planet where they're on, this is a place of the greatest The greatest masters of yoga lived there.
Tapaloka 是那些最伟大的瑜伽师的居所。
And they've totally controlled their sex desire.
他们彻底地控制了性欲。
And the happiness on Tapaloka is millions of times greater than that of the Prajapatis.
Tapaloka 上居民的快乐要比Prajapati 们感受的快乐强100万倍。
So Pipalayana is saying to Gop Kumar, well, why would you want to go any other place? You're so fortunate to come to this place.
所以 Pipalayana 就说，你为什么要去别的地方呢？你已经来到这么幸运的地方。
And then Pipalayana tells Gop Kumar, he said, you should concentrate your mind in meditation.
皮帕拉亚纳又对戈帕库马说：“你应该将心意专注于冥想。”
If you will meditate, you will automatically see the Lord everywhere, within and without.
如果你专注于冥想，你就能在每一个地方见到至尊主，无论是在内在还是外在。
When you see the Lord.In this way, it will be like he's always with you in person.
当你以这种方式去看至尊主的时候，这就相当于你亲自和主在一起了。
So Gop Kumar may be wondering why he shouldn't go where he can directly see the Supreme Lord.
Gopa Kumar 可能纳闷，他为什么不能去那个可以亲自直接的见到主的地方呢？
But Pipalayana, he's telling him that instead of focusing your attention outside on some with your eyes, focus your attention within.
但是 Pipalayana 的意见是说，你不应当将注意力放在外在，相反，应该把注意力转向内在。
If you can fully cultivate meditation, if you can practice this meditation successfully, you can reach the stage of samadhi.
如果你能以这种方式培养冥想的话，就能达到 samadhi 神定的境界了。
And then the form of the Lord will manifest itself on its own strength.
之后主的形象就会以他自己的力量显示。
You don't have to do anything yourself. It will happen automatically.
你不需要自己额外的努力，它将自动的发生。
Just like a person's face appears in a clean mirror.
就好像一个人的面容就在清澈的水中反射出来。
So if Gop Kumar follows this recommendation, if he follows the yoga process, he will see the Supreme Lord.You'll see the Lord within and without.
如果 Gopal Kumar 遵守他的建议的话，去这样冥想，他将在内心和在心外都见到主。
At least it will appear like that, although actually the Supreme Lord cannot be seen with the eyes.
至少他显得是这样，尽管事实上是不能用肉眼看到主的。
So in this way, the Pipalayana, the sage, wants to tell Gop Kumar, there's no use wandering around to find him. He's there within your heart.
Pipalayana 告诉 Gopal Kumar, 你没有去到处漫游去寻找至尊主，去见至尊主是没有用的，他就在你的心中啊。
And Pipalayana tells Gop Kumar, Lord Vasudeva is the Supreme Soul.And he has a form of eternity, knowledge, and bliss.
圣者继续告诉 Gopal Kumar 说，主 Vasudeva 他是至尊主，他拥有永恒知识、极乐的形象。
And he will reveal himself in the pure heart, nowhere else.
他只在纯净的内心当中显现，而不是在其他的地方显现。
So Lord Vasudeva appears within the heart.
所以主 Vasudeva 是在心中显现。
It's more subtle than the mind.
它比心意更加精微。
And this is described by Lord Shiva in the fourth canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
主 Shiva 在圣典薄伽瓦坛第四篇也形容了这一点。
He describes that the stage of pure consciousness, meaning Krishna consciousness, is where the Supreme Lord is revealed.
他主 Shiva 形容说，纯粹的知觉，也就是 Krishna 知觉，是在纯净的心中展示的。
And when he is revealed without any covering, then this is called Vasudeva.
当他在没有覆盖的情况下揭示的时候，这就被称为是 Vasudeva。
So in that pure state, Lord Shiva said, "I always offer my obeisances to the Supreme Lord."
因此，在这个纯净的阶段，主 Shiva 说：“我恒常的向至尊主致以顶拜。”
And that Lord is known as Vasudeva.And he's beyond the material senses.
那位主被称为是 Vasudeva, 他超越了感官之上。
So when our consciousness is completely pure, then it will reflect nothing but the Supreme.
当我们知觉纯净之后，它反射出来的就只有至尊主了。
And it's only then that Lord Vasudeva reveals himself.
而且只有在那个时候，主才揭示他自己。
He reveals himself in the heart.
他在内心揭示他自己。
Lord Vasudeva, he is the essence of the supreme truth.
主 Vasudeva 是至尊真理的精华。
The external senses cannot understand him.
外在的感官无法理解他。
So when we have nothing else going on in our mind, then we will have direct vision of Lord Hari.
当我们心意里头已经没有其他的活动的时候，主 Vasudeva 就在那里显现了。
So nothing else going on in the mind except vision of Lord Hari.Our eyes will take place. Only one's eyes take place in the heart.
在这个阶段的时候，一个人就会将视域转向内在。
So Pipalayana, he's telling Gop Kumar about the meditation process.
Pipalayana 就这样告诉 Gopa Kumar 的冥想的方法。
So here, Pipalayana, this sage understands the doubt of Gop Kumar.
Pipalayana 能够明白 Gopa Kumar 的疑惑。
The doubt is, if the meditation which is being described is valid, and we directly perceive the Lord with our eyes.
他的疑惑就是说倘若这个冥想的程序是真实无期的话，可以在内在看到主。
So Pipalayana, he argues back that when one seems to be, if we think we're seeing the Lord with our eyes, but we're actually seeing him with our heart, not with our eyes.
Pipalaya 牧尼的意见是说，好，表面上好像我们在用眼睛看主，那实际上我们是用心在看主。
It's only after the mind puts away all the other sense objects, then the Lord reveals himself in the heart.
只有当心意把其他的一切对象都推出去的时候，主才会显现他自己。
And it's the mind that performs the work of seeing the Lord.
这时候心意就会行使它去看见主的功能。
But the person who's seeing the Lord, he's not conscious of that.
但是那位在目睹主的人，他没有意识到这一点。
The person who's seeing the Lord, he's thinking, I'm seeing the Lord with my eyes.
去观看主的。
Oh no, I'm not seeing with my eyes. I'm seeing with my mind.
去看观看主的这个人，他在想，我不是在用我的眼睛去看主，我是在用心意去看主。
So this is the realization of the Lord.
这就是对主的觉悟。
And this is the power of the mind allows us to see the Lord.
这就是心意的力量，允许我们可以看见主。
But the eyes, they have very limited scope.
但是肉眼它的范围是非常有限的。
The eyes cannot understand the transcendental form of the Lord.
主，眼睛不能理解主的超然形体。
The different bodily limbs of the Lord and the beautiful features of the Lord, they are only realized by the purified souls.
主的精巧的四肢，他美丽的面容，只有那些觉悟的灵魂才能看到。
So we have to have such a pure heart.That we have no material desires, and then the Lord reveals Himself in our mind.
所以我们必须有纯净的心灵，这样主才会向我们揭示他自己。
And when the mind is happy, then all the senses are also happy.
一旦心意快乐了，所有感官也感到快乐。
The different functions of the body, like the speaking and seeing and hearing, all the things which the senses do, they're all functioning around the mind.
言语的功能，眼睛的去视觉的功能以及听觉的功能，都是围绕着。心意在行使各自的职能。
All these activities like that, seeing and touching, taste, they're all these activities that are actually included in the function of the mind.
视听嗅触的功能，实际上都已经在心意的功能之内了。
So Gop Kumar, he prefers to actually see with the eye.
Gopa Kumar 宁愿是用双眼去看主。
He thinks to see with the mind that's some abstract enjoyment.
他认为用心意去看主是一个非常抽象的享受。
But this Pipalina, he is telling Gop Kumar that the happiness of the mind is much greater.
琵琶拉雅纳告诉戈帕库玛，心意的快乐要更伟大。
And the happiness of the mind is not just dealing with the eyes, but with all the senses.
心意的快乐不仅仅包括视觉的快乐，而且包含了所有感官的快乐。
Just when the mind is distressed, the senses will also they be disturbed.
当心意感到悲伤的时候，所有的感官也都相应的受到打扰。
They won't feel any happiness.
他们感受不到快乐。
Because the senses will not even be involved in to contact their objects.
那个时候，感官甚至都不会去与感官对象发生接触。
So there's a relationship between the happiness of the mind and the happiness of the senses.
因此，心意的快乐和感官的快乐是紧密相连的。
And it's natural and it's automatic.
它是自然而然的，也是终极的。
All of the senses are rooted in the mind.
所有的感官它们的根源都在心意。
Just like the branches and the leaves of a tree,
They get nourished from the tree when the tree is watered at the roots.
正像树枝和树叶，它们都是当树根被浇水的时候，枝枝叶叶也都得到养分、水分。
So when the mind is satisfied, then the senses will also be satisfied.
一旦心意满足了，所有感官也都满足了。
And no need, there's no need for them to make any special effort on their own.
这些感官没有必要单独去做出努力。
But Gop Kumar says that what the mind does when one remembers what the mind does, it's still short of what the organs.Like the tongue and the eyes, that they do much more. Gop Kumar says that what the mind does when we remember is not equal.To what we do with the senses.
Gopa Kumar他表示说心意当他运作的时候和感官运作的时候他们两个的效果是不一样的。
We use the senses, we can use them for chanting and for seeing the Lord.
我们可以用感官去唱诵去看主。
So we should understand that the senses are all meant for the service of the Supreme Lord.
我们要明白感官应该是用来服务至尊主。
And the senses enjoy greater pleasure than the mind.
感官可以享受到超过心意能够享受到的快乐。
Bipalina, he says that the functions of the senses are included in the function of the mind.
Bipalina 说的根据他的意见感官的功能已经囊括在心意的功能里面了。
So chanting the names of the Lord and seeing the deity, all these things, they're activities of the senses.
唱诵主，去崇拜主，看主的形象，这都已经包含在心意的功能里。
And all these activities are made possible by the actions of the mind.
所有这些活动之所以能够可能变得可能，都是由于心意的功能。
Without the functions of the mind, the functions of all the senses will be useless.
如果心意它丧失了功能，那我们所有的感官也都不再能够行使各自的功能。
Even if somebody is doing activities, whatever he does, it will be as if he never did anything.
即便一个人他好像在那里活动，那实际上他也是什么都没有做的。
So this is the argument of Gop Kumar.
这就是 Gopa Kumar 的他的论点。
He's saying, when the mind is inattentive, then the senses may still be active.
即便心意并不是专注的时候，感官也依然能够保持活跃状态。
So the senses may be active, but they cannot make any real connection with their objects.
即便感官很活跃，它和感官对象也没有联系，没有联系在一起。
Each of our senses have its own object.
每一个感官都有各自的感官对象。
Just like for the eyes.There's a sense of sight.
比如说眼睛它可以去看。
and the sense of sight, we can detect all the different forms.
视欲可以觉知到不同的形体。
And with the skin, we can touch things and we can feel the texture.
皮肤可以去感受，感这个物体的它的结构，精微的结构。
So the purpose of the senses is achieved when they connect with their objects.
当感官和感官对象联系在一起的时候，感官就已经实现了它的目标。
And when they're connected with their objects, then we can connect with everything.
当感官和感官对象产生接触粉，产生接触的时候，它就能够有感知。
So we perceive, we can recognize these different things by the senses.
我们可以透过感官来认知感官对象。
We need the mind, however, and we need the soul.
我们需要心意，然而我们也需要灵魂。
It's not enough just to have a body with senses. There has to be the mind and the soul.
一个躯体仅仅是有一个躯体及其感官还不够，还得有心意以及灵魂。
So if the mind is not focused on some sense object, then there will be no sensation. There will be nothing will reach the soul.
如果心意没有专注于感官对象，那么它就不会有感知，它就不会有感知，而且这种感觉出的冲动也不会达到灵魂。
And there will be no conscious result.
也不会有存在有觉知的结果。
So from everyday life, we can understand this situation.
我们可以从日常生活当中明白这种情况。
So people is arguing, he's saying that just seeing God is in reality the Lord showing himself through the functions of one's purified consciousness.
皮巴拉说到仅仅用眼睛用感官去看观看主。它必须要透过心意的功能才能够实现。
It's different from directly seeing God with your eyes.
它和用眼睛直接去看主有区别。
The Lord is outside the activities of the senses. He's beyond the senses.
主超越了感官的活动。
But if the Lord, out of his compassion for his devotee, if he will reveal himself to their eyes, then that vision occurs.
一旦主对出于对奉献者的对奉献者表示怜悯的时候，那么这个奉献者就可以用眼睛肉眼看观看到主了。
So this, we actually see this by the power of the mind.
我们这是真正的是透过心意的力量去看的。
We are thinking we're seeing with the eyes, but actually it's because of the mind.
我们以为我们是在用肉眼去看，那实际上呢，是在透过心意。
So we can say, what about devotees like Dhruva and Prahlad?Don't they see the Lord directly?
我们可能会说，那么朱瓦和普拉德他们又怎么样呢？难道他们不是直接在看见主吗？
Aren't they famous for having seen the Lord in person?
难道他们不是因为能够面对面见到主而闻名于世吗？
The Lord made himself visible to those great devotees.Because of his love for them.
主之所以让这些伟大奉献者能够看见自己，是因为他对出于对他们的爱。
So he wanted to show them his fatherly affection.
主希望向这些奉献者展示他的父爱。
He wanted to give them that to satisfy the purpose of their eyes.
他希望能够满足这些奉献者的眼睛的功能。
So Pipalaya is saying that the devotees, they have these revelations. They see the Lord through pure consciousness.
Pipalaya 牧尼说，这些奉献者是透过纯净的知觉，能够使得主接着他们自己。
They do not just see him through the physical eyes.
其实奉献者并不是透过他们的肉眼去看到主。
So the scope of our eyes is very limited, what we can see with our eyes. There's many things we cannot see.
我们的视觉范围是非常有限的，有许多是看不到的。
So why are Dhruva and Prahlad and others so famous for having seen the Lord?
为什么Dhruva、Prahlad 和其他人因为见到主而变得如此的文明呢？
And why is he famous as Bhakta Vatsala?
而为什么主又以 Vatsala 而闻名呢？
Bhakta Vatsala means he who shows affection to his devotees.
Bhakta Vatsala 的意思是主对他的奉献者非常慈爱。
So this is because the jivas, they're always identifying with their own senses.
个体灵魂他们总是和感官认同。
And they would think I'm seeing the Lord directly with my eyes.
他们会以为我是直接在用肉眼去看主。
Those devotees, so devotees thought that was the only way to see the Lord.
奉献者以为这是去见到主的唯一的方法。
And this is the way to satisfy the Supreme Lord.
这是取悦至尊主的方法。
The power of the eyes to see the Lord is so. It doesn't mean that the eyes are useless. The eyes are useful, but certain things which they're not useful for.
这并不意味着眼睛就没有用了，眼睛是有用途的。
So when we say that seeing God is beyond the power of the eyes, it doesn't mean that the eyes are useless.
当主他超越了这个肉眼的力量的范畴之上的时候，这并不意味着肉眼就没用了。
And so even if by the mercy of the Lord, if the Lord becomes visible to the eye, then the bliss that you get from seeing him, that's going to naturally come in our heart.
如果一个人能够用肉眼能够用视力能够去看到主的话，那么这他感受到的极乐就会透过眼睛直达他的内心心灵。
The Lord is free to do what anything he wants. If he wants to reveal himself to the devotees, he can.
倘若主希望能将自己揭示给奉献者的话，他可以自由自在的去揭示。
And some people, so miracles happen. When miracles happen, is for the benefit. Of the, it's for the benefit of these conditioned souls to save them from material life.
当奇迹发生的时候，是为了受条件限制的灵魂的好处，把他们从物质生活当中拯救出来。
So it's for the benefit of the conditioned souls, not just for the souls.
It's not just for that, the senses of the soul.
所以这是为了灵魂的好处，而不是为了这个灵魂所拥有的感官的好处。
So the Lord is compassionate towards the conditioned souls.
主对受条件限制灵魂充满怜悯。
And sometimes the physical eyes are able to see the Lord.
有的时候肉眼是可以去看见主。
It depends on the desire of the Lord.
这也取决于主的愿望。
But just seeing the Lord, the pleasure that we get from it will come. The pleasure will come the pleasure that's always going to come from the mind.
但是当用肉眼去看主的时候，这个快乐是透过心意。
Yeah. Just like pain and anxiety, this also comes from the mind. So the same way, pleasure also comes from the mind.
就像痛苦和愿望是在心意中发生的，同样快乐也是在心意里发生的。
So you see the Lord, you feel pleasure, that pleasure is in the mind.
所以你看主，然后感到快乐，这种快乐是发生在心意里。
And that feeling, that pleasure, that bliss which we feel, it continues in the heart. Even after the Lord is no longer visible to the eyes, still you feel the pleasure in the heart.
因此，即便当主从视域中消失，肉眼不再能够看见主的时候，心意仍然能够持续地感受到快乐。
And that who's getting that happiness? That happiness is the mind.
是谁在得到获得这份快乐呢？是心意在获得这份快乐。
After you meet the Lord, when he is no longer visible to the eyes, you still have that pleasure. You still feel so good.
当你遇到主之后，主又消失的时候，你的心意仍然在感受着快乐。
Because within our heart we'll be thinking, oh, with my own eyes I saw Krishna, I saw him right before me.
因为你会在心意里想，哦，我在用我的双眼直接的看，我能用我的双眼直接的看到了主。
So that feeling in the heart continues after the eyes can no longer see him.
所以这种内心的快乐仍会持续，即便是肉眼已经不再能够看到主。
So that ecstasy is in the heart.
所以这份狂喜是在内心。
So it's the mind which is actually seeing the Lord. It's not the eyes.
所以是心意，看见主的是心意，而不是肉眼。
So seeing, that is one of the knowledge acquiring senses, to be able to use our eyes to see. That's how we get knowledge.
眼睛是获得知识的感官。
So why should we be unable to generate and maintain happiness? We should be able to feel constant happiness.
我们应该能够恒常的感受快乐。
Why don't we feel constant happiness?
为什么我们不能感受恒常持续的快乐呢？
So the answer is given by the self-realized sages.
这个答案，自我觉悟的圣者们给出了答案。
They say that that if we want to reach that pleasure of seeing the Lord in the mind,
他们说
we have to come to that stage to see the Lord in the mind.
他们说，倘若我们希望达到这个，能够用心意去看观看主的快乐，那么我们应该去。我们应该试图去用心意去看主。
It's by the mind we can see the Lord.
正是凭借着心意，我们才能去观看主。
So the mind is compared to the, just like a king has ministers. So the mind is like a minister, one of the ministers.
打的这个一个比喻，就好像是国王他有这个大臣，心意就好像大臣。
And it's just like a king has some ministers, so he will give a lot of responsibility to the ministers to take care of many valuable things in his treasury or his kingdom.
就好像一个国王，他有着大臣，他会委以重任，让他们负责对国家的财政和其他事务。
So in the same way, the mind works like that, performing many different functions.
同样的，心意也是这样运作的，它有自己的功能。
So, the more our mind is peaceful, then the more we will feel that pleasure.
我们的心意越是平和，就越能感受着快乐。
And None of our senses can feel that kind of pleasure.
没有一个感官能够感受这份快乐。
Some people may say, "Oh, well, the mind is limited. What can do?"
有的人会说，哦，心意是有限的，它又能做些什么呢？
Just like our senses are limited, so mind is also limited.
正如我们的感官是有限的，我们的心意也是有限的。
Well, that we agree. That's true.
我们同意，这是确实是如此。
But when the mind becomes free of contamination, then the Lord becomes satisfied. Then the Lord is satisfied, and He's prepared to give us His mercy.
但是，当我们的心意变得平和的时候，主就会感到满意，就会愿意给我们仁慈。
So the pure consciousness has to be reflected in the mind.
纯粹的知觉必须是在心意当中反射出来。
And then it will be able to maintain the image of the Supreme Lord.
这样我们才能够维持主的形象。
But our external senses are not able to do this.
但我们外在的感官做不到这一点。
So in this way, we're hearing about the power of meditation and how we should focus the mind.
我们就这样聆听到了，冥想的力量以及该如何专注。
Okay, we'll stop here today.
好，那我们今天的正课就停在这里。
We'll ask if there's some questions.
那有没有问题？
Yeah.
我想问的，主为什么经常会出现在不同的奉献者面前，右眼看见 但是为什么 Lobama 是他的第一个生物体，但是他就很长时间都不给他看见，只是他心里的承诺，为什么他没有给他看见，就看下好像是很迟很往后的时间才给他，为什么不一开始很久都没给 Lobama 看见他哭了，就是心里。
My question is that the Lord always reveal himself to devotees. Then why the first living entity, Lord Brahma, why the Lord didn't reveal himself to the first living entity, Lord Brahma?
Well, the Lord did. He did reveal himself to Lord Brahma.
Her question is that for a long time, the Lord didn't reveal.
Well, he had to purify himself first.
主 Brahma 首先要净化自己。
He had to qualify himself to see the Lord.
他必须让自己有资格能够看见主。
The Lord, Lord Brahma got the instruction tapa to do austerities, and so he did them for a long time.
主 Brahma 就得到了一个训示 tapa, 所以他做了很长时间的苦行。
And then he saw the Lord.
之后他见到了主。
And how
did the Lord Brahma see in the mind, in the heart, or with the eyes?
Well, according to how it's described here, it's.From the heart.
根据我们今天在这里读到的，他是从内心看到的。
But then later on, the Lord comes and personally shakes his hand.
哦，那后来呢？主就到来了，和他握手了。
Yogita.
因为主无处不在，所以你在内心看见主和在外在看见主是没有区别的，你能不能解释？
Well, the point is that if you see the Lord either outside or inside, the consciousness of the Lord is there. The consciousness is there of the Lord. Somebody is conscious of the Lord inside in the heart. Someone else is seeing the Lord externally.
所以不管是外在看见主还是内在看见主，必须有这份知觉在那里。
You know, just like we can say, well, I'm seeing the Lord, the light of the sun. Krishna said, I am the light of the sun. So I'm seeing the light of the sun, so I'm seeing the Lord. So somebody else, they're seeing the Lord in the Lord is in the heart. I'm meditating on the Lord in the heart.
有的人说至尊主主 Krishna 说我是太阳，我是日月的光华，那我看到他了，我已经见到主了。有的人说主在心中，我就看心中的主。
Is there a difference? Well, it's the same Lord, but different features.
那这两种有没有区别呢？是同一位主，但是主是以不同的特征展示他自己。
So somebody sees the Lord through his energies, and somebody else sees the Lord through his expansions.
有的人透过主的能量看到主，有的人透过主的扩展看主。
So here in Papadopoulos, just satisfied by seeing the Lord through his energies.
They're seeing the Lord in the form of the super soul, in the heart.
在塔帕洛克上的居民们，在那里的人们，他们满足于去看看他们心中的主。
What questions are there online?
自身主 Krishna， 而那不是五千年前 Krishna 来时，独有坦他们这些众多的坏人能看到 Krishna， 是不是他们也被 Krishna 给予了灵性眼睛才能看到 Krishna 呢？感恩。
You say that we cannot see the Lord with our eyes, but 5,000 years ago.Duryodhan, those evil kings, they also saw the Lord. Is that the Lord has given them the spiritual visions that they can saw the Lord?
Well, Duryodhan didn't actually see the Lord. He thought he saw the Lord covered by yoga maya.
Duryodhan 没有真正的看见主。他被Yoga Maya附蒙蔽了。
He thought of Krishna as an ordinary person. He didn't see him as the Supreme Lord.
他把主就看成普通人，他没有把主看成把 Krishna 看成至尊主。
第二个问题，感谢翻译，请问 Tapaloka 的居民。是冥想主超人的形象吗？是四臂的 Vishnu 还是两臂的岩珠主 Vishnu 的形象？
The question is that the residents of Tapaloka, what are they meditating? Is that the four-armed super soul form or the two-armed original form?
The four-armed super soul.
四臂的超灵形象。
三位的是精微虚底由心力自信假我组成，假我是否在心力自信之上？假我是我们的卡玛的展现吗？
The subtle bodies consist of mind, intelligence and the false ego, and the false ego is above mind and intelligence. May I ask, We have the four ego. Is that due to our karma?
Well, false ego. Yeah, you could say it's our karma. It's part of our subtle body. So, yes, you can say it's karma that we're here in the material world because we have karma. So we have a material body, and part of that material body is false ego.
可以这样说。因为假我也是精微躯体的组成部分，而我们现在处在物质世界，我们的躯体的组成部分之一也由假我组成，所以可以说也是由我们的业报。
来自梦外小组的导论，他说亲属呢已经离世的家人的钱财。就是属清楚用已经离开，就是离开，就是已经离开这个躯体的那个的他们的钱财做婚外夫，他们会得到什么好处？如果这个钱用去感官享乐的话，那么已经离世的那个人是否也要承担这个业报？
My question is related to the money of the past relative. If you use the money for devotional service, what benefit will be given to the past relatives? If we use the money for sense gratification, do they also have the karmic reaction on the past relatives?
Well, the idea is if you use your mind for devotional service and you become a pure devotee, then it will definitely be beneficial to your past relatives.
这个要点就是如果你自己成为一位纯粹的奉献者，那么无疑就会给那个去世的亲属带来巨大的好处。
But I've never heard that the past relatives are responsible for your karma. I don't think the past relatives have any involvement in your karma.
The question is that if we use the money, they left the money for sense gratification, will they also are there also any karma on the part of the past relatives?
No.
No. 哦、oh. ，就是如果我们用他们这些去世的亲属的钱用来感官享乐，那么这些去世的亲属不会因此而招致业报反应，对他们来说没有不再有业报反应了。What's the benefit if we use their money to do?
I said the benefit if you become a pure devotee.
Okay. 就是如果你自己变成一个纯粹的奉献者，那就是要点就是说你自己要做一个纯粹的奉献者，那么就能给这些去世的亲属，带来好处。
哦，还是主动的布施和被动的布施所得到的好处是不是一样的？
What's the difference between voluntary donation and passive donation?
Passive?
We are forced to do, forced to give some donation.
Oh, forced. Well, if you give something grudgingly, then it's not done in the mode of goodness. Then it's the mode of passion.
如果就是满腹牢骚的给布施的话，这不是善良形态的布施，而是激情形态的布施。
Or it may even be the mode of ignorance.
甚至可能是处在愚昧形态的布施。
So the mode of passion, the mode of ignorance, they will give a different result from the mode of goodness.
处在善良、处在激情和愚昧形态下面的活动和善良的不一样。
You give in the mode of goodness, it will purify you.
在善良形态的布施会净化人。
But you give in the mode of passion and ignorance, it will degrade you.
而激情和愚昧属性的布施会让人降格堕落。
可以把恒河的那个沙，就是恒河的沙在家里面的撒在花园，家里面的花园嘛，这样可不可以把家也变成了圣地？
May I ask if we throw the sand in the Ganga, will that purify my garden and make my home the holy place?
We throw sand in the Ganga?
Yes.
Will it purify?
The garden.
I don't see the connection between the garden.
If because the garden there, the sand is from the Ganga, the holy place, and then it will purify the garden and make the garden a Tirtha, holy dam.
Well, they're bringing sand from the Ganga.
Yeah, bring the sand from India.
To put in their garden.
Yes.
No.
不能。不能。
然后通过心意可以看见，他说通过心意可以看见主。那么冥想跟心意有什么关联
？Through the mind, we can see the Lord. What's the relationship between mind and meditation?
Well, you have to
Meditation means controlling the mind and fixing the mind on the form of the Lord.
冥想意味着要控制心意，将心意专注于主。
Usually our mind is absorbed meditating on sense gratification.
一般呢，我们的心意都是专注于感官享乐。
Our eyes, our different senses are all they're all thinking about enjoying.
我们的心意里有五花八门的享受。
And our mind meditates on all the different thoughts of sense enjoyment.
我们的心意就冥想着感官享乐的不同的念头。
But real meditation is to fix the mind on the form of the Lord.
真正的冥想就是将心意专注于主的形象。
Remembering the different qualities and features of the Lord.
意念主的品质，主的不同的身体特征。
Meditating on the different bodily limbs of the Lord.
冥想主的各个肢体四肢。
心意比感官强大。梦呢是心意的产物吗？什么样自己做的梦都是灵性的呢？然后睡觉前呢，看帕乌巴德的《逍遥甘露》，什么晚上还会做感官享乐的梦？
The mind is powerful than the senses.
梦是心意的产物吗？
And is that my dream is the product of the mind?
怎么样做好？怎么样让自己做的梦都是灵性的？
How can my dream all become spiritual dream?
When you purify your mind,
当净化你的心，您的精。
When you give up your desire for enjoying the senses,
当您放弃了要享受感官的愿望。
Then you stop dreaming about sense gratification.
之后您就会放弃，做梦想着感官享乐了。
So you need to hear and chant.More.
所以您需要更多的去聆听唱诵。
You need to become absorbed in thinking about the pastimes of Krishna.
您需要专注心意去想着主的逍遥时光。
Then you can start to think more about Krishna and dream about Krishna.
之后您就可以开始梦见 Krishna, 想着 Krishna.
我们用亲属的钱会承担他们的业报吗？我们意思是我们用我们亲属的钱。
Yes.
会承担业报。
If you take money from your relatives, you definitely will take their karma.
你拿了你亲属的钱，肯定的就要承担他们的业报了。
但是你还有一个不太明白，他说。我们所有的奉献都是 Krishna 的牺牲品吗？如果是，目的是什么？成就是什么？成就什么？目的是什么？这个有点好像不太理解。
所有的奉献是 Krishna 的牺牲品，
看不懂。
下一个。
他说：“你讲的心意是通过感官来感知外在的世界，并同时做出反应。”心意的纯净度决定了我们对外在的接受能力，是吗？然后，所有的真正的进化是心意的进化。所以我跟黄哥里面说，我 Krishna 说吧，我适应的对皈依我的程度呢，沐浴恩泽，意思是心意的皈依，而不是外在的皈依。我的意思是不是这样？
Buddha, you mentioned that the mind is to perceive the outer world through the senses the mind can perceive the world and to give response and the purity of the mind decide of the receptive of our the power of our receptive, right?
There are
several parts of questions.
The duty of the mind is to The mind can perceive the outside world through the senses.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, and then?
And then the purity of the senses will decide the degree of our power to receive the accept the outer world.
Well, it's the purity of the heart. It's the heart, the purity of the mind, the heart. That is what is not the, it's not the senses, it's the purity of the heart. You purify the heart.
The true purification is the purification of the mind, right?
Yes.
是的，真正的净化是心的净化。所以梵歌中说，therefore in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, I respond accordingly. Therefore, it is the mind, the mind is surrendering. And now the Krishna is saying that the surrendering is.Surrendering of the mind, not the appearance we are surrendered, but we should surrender by our mind.
Okay.
你说对。
压力没有很好水的时候，就是可以把很好沙放到纯净水，然后是不是就是很好水？
If we don't have the Ganga water, can we put the sand, Ganga sand in the purified water and then it become 成为纯
就变成好像水了
then it become a Ganga water.
No.
不行。
不是。
不是。
But you can chant mantra to call the holy rivers.
您可以通过念诵 mantra 来召唤圣河显现。
Usually devotees that will do that.
通常
chant the mantra, call all the holy rivers.
奉献者通常是来念诵 mantra 来召唤所有的圣河显现在这个
The holy rivers are all eager to serve Krishna.
因为所有的圣河都渴望服务主 Krishna.
So they all appear.
所以所有的圣河便显现了。
他把罗卡上的人们虽然通过冥想主就已经心满意足了，可是当他们听说主在温达文的逍遥时光的时候，他们就感受到不一样的快乐。他们已经离 Krishna Loka 不远了，怎么还不会心生渴望的去追寻更高的那个快乐，更高层面的快乐呢？
The Tapa Loka is not far away from.Goloka. Why the residents there don't hunger to why don't they want to go to Goloka Vrindavan to experience the much higher happiness?
Because they're already they're satisfied in the self. They're experiencing that satisfaction just being there in Tapaloka. They don't have that desire for anything more.
因为他们是感受着就是在塔帕洛克上面感受着心意的平和，他们在自我当中已经满足了，他们就没有别的愿望。
在冥想的时候，应该冥想哪个主的哪个形象好
？When we meditate, what form of the Lord should we meditate?
We should meditate on the form. Well, the yogis they will meditate on the super soul, the four-armed form.
瑜伽师会冥想超灵四臂的形体。
And for devotees. We have to do hearing and chanting.
对于奉献者呢，我们要去聆听和唱诵。
Before you can remember Krishna, before you can meditate, first you have to hear and chant.
在您能够开始冥想做的冥想之前呢，要首先去聆听以及唱诵。
If you haven't done enough hearing and chanting, you will not be able to meditate successfully.
如果没有足够的聆听唱诵，是不能成功的冥想的。
带回家里的恒河的那个沙可以做什么服务？
The sand when may I ask what service can the sand we brought back from the Ganga?
You can use it.To put the incense, when you're burning incense, you can stand the incense in the sun.
那么就是您可以，当您点香的时候呢，您可以把香插在这个恒河沙里。
没有。
Okay. Okay. So finish here today.
那我们今天就到这里了。外昆达知音服务园林厅，非常感谢。各位奉献者的聆听，感谢所有的好的问题，也感谢圣巴克维克纳什纳辛亚玛拉给我们带来精彩的讲课。祝大家有个愉快的一天，哈里克什纳，下周见。